Let's take a look at a new smartphone from a company that is new to the US market. This is the Wiko Ride. Follow me on Instagram at KevinBreezeTV. Please join the Kevin Breeze Tech community on Facebook to chat about budget smartphones, ask questions, and help others. Hi everyone, this is Kevin here, coming at you with my unboxing and first impressions video of the Wiko Ride. Now this device is a Boost Mobile exclusive, and I'd like to thank Wiko for being kind enough to send it out to me to review. In addition to them sending me out the device, they also sent me a bunch of really cool swag. I really appreciate Wiko sending all of this out to me, and I plan on doing more coverage about the brand in addition to the typical unboxing and review videos. I'm going to be doing a video coming out soon discussing Wiko and introducing you to the brand itself, so stay tuned for that. But it's always very exciting seeing new brands making their way over to the US market. Wiko is especially big in Europe at the moment and in other parts of the world, so it'll be really interesting to see how they break into things over here in the US. Now the Wiko Ride is available at Boost Mobile for $39.99. Now we do have some of the specification highlights here on the front of the box, but we'll be going over those throughout the video. But you can see we have the typical Boost Mobile box here with the picture of the device on the front. We have kind of the same thing on the back. And the process of setting this device up with Boost Mobile is super simple. It's as simple as picking a plan, activating the phone, and paying for that plan. Now with Boost Mobile, you have the flexibility of either going into a physical retail store to get everything set up and to buy the device, or you can do everything online. So you can do whatever works for you. I've now opened up the box. We're gonna slide this out, and it looks like we have a box within a box. So it says Wiko Ride right here. Again, here are some of the specifications of the device. I'm gonna pull this tab open. And in the box, we have a variety of different items. Of course, we have the actual phone itself, which I'll be putting off to the side right now. We have a USB wall adapter for charging. We have a micro USB cable for charging and data transfer. We have the 2500 milliamp hour battery with Wiko branding on it. And we have the safety and warranty guide. We'll now take the phone out of the plastic here. And here is the device itself. Now it does come with a plastic screen protector on the top here, and it's definitely optional whether or not you want to leave that on. I'm gonna be leaving it on at the moment, but I might take it off in a little bit. I'm gonna remove the back though right now and insert the battery. I've now inserted the battery. We have the slot for the micro SD card right here, and we have the SIM card slot, which came for me preloaded with a Boost Mobile SIM card. We're gonna put the back on right now, and let's boot this up. Here we go, Wiko Game Changer powered by Android, Wiko Ride. I've now set everything up, and here is the Wiko Ride. Now, this device features a 5.5-inch display featuring a resolution of 480 by 960, so the display itself is under 720p. It features a PPI of 197, and for a device that comes in at $40, that's to be expected. Now, up top here, we have a 2-megapixel front-facing camera. Then on the back, we have a 5-megapixel rear-facing camera. The device features 16 gigabytes of internal storage, and it has micro SD card expansion, as I showed you a little bit ago. There's no wireless charging with this phone, and there's no fingerprint sensor. Now the device features 2 gigabytes of RAM and runs the MediaTek Helio A22 processor. I've personally never used a Helio A22, so I'm definitely interested to see the kind of performance that we're gonna get with this phone. And again, like I mentioned before, my expectations for this phone are not extremely high, just because the device is available for just $40. So you have to take that into consideration. Now battery capacity is 2,500 milliamp hours, and we do have Android 9 Pie out of the box, and that's a really great thing to see. I really do appreciate that this device runs the latest version of Android. Now overall, I'm a big fan of this large display on the phone. It certainly comes in handy when watching videos, whether that's on YouTube or Netflix, or browsing the web and reading articles, or even going on social media. There's just a lot of advantages with having a device with a large display. And we do have decently large bezels on the top and bottom, but again, for $40, there are gonna be compromises. That's just the way it is. Now on the left side, we have nothing. On the right side, we have the power button and volume rocker. On the top, we have the noise-canceling microphone and 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. On the bottom, we have the microphone and micro USB port. And on the backside, we have that 5-megapixel rear-facing camera, we have the flash, we have the Wiko logo, and we have the speaker. and this design on the backside is definitely pretty cool and unique. I'm going to be using the Wico Ride quite a bit to get a good idea of whether or not it's a good phone to buy. So far, I like what I see, especially for a phone that's only $40. But I want to know what you think. Are you excited that the Wico brand is making its way into the US? Would you like to see more phones from Wico on US carriers or available factory unlocked? Let me know down below in the comment section. But again, thank you, Wico, for sending this out to me to review. I'm looking forward to potentially working with them in the future on a variety of different projects. I'm super excited about this brand making its way into the US, and having Wico in the US creates more competition and gives consumers more options. But I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe and like it, and I'll see you in the next one.